the state. That does not mean the state won't see any impacts. Press News' Amanda Rowley is joining us now live in downtown Spokane to share what the next steps are here in Washington. Thank you.
financial support for states to create or administer red flag laws to temporarily remove guns from individuals deemed to be a threat, expanded investments in mental health and school safety resources, and then finally enhanced background checks for gun buyers under 21. That's it. It's coming today after the Supreme Court has ended up the right to nullify the New York law that required applicants. Power. The U.S. Senate passed a bipartisan bill to reduce new gun restrictions and billions of dollars in security and health. The first compromise on gun legislation by that chamber.
But it came just hours after the Supreme Court scandal gun rights by striking down the rule clause. It seems Jay O'Brien has more in Washington.
Overnight, the Senate, breaking decades of partisan gridlock, passing a compromise gun safety bill.
It doesn't do everything I want. But what we are doing will save thousands of lives.
The $13 billion measure includes enhanced background checks for anyone under the age of 21 buying a gun, closes the so-called boyfriend loophole, preventing people convicted of domestic violence from owning guns, and provides federal funding for gun violence prevention programs, school security, and mental health.
The yeas are 65, the nays are 30.
Democrats passing the bill. The legislation now headed to the House for an expected vote today, spurred by calls for action after recent mass shootings in Buffalo and Uvalde. But hours earlier in Washington, the Supreme Court delivering a stinging defeat for gun safety advocates in a landmark 6-3 decision, the justices striking down New York's century-old gun law, which required anyone seeking a license to carry a concealed handgun show they have a special need for it. Justice Clarence Thomas said that violates the Second Amendment. Writing for the majority, we know of no other constitutional right that an individual may exercise only after demonstrating to government officers some special need. The court's decision divided between its 6 conservatives and 3 liberals. In his dissent, Justice Stephen Breyer noted the nearly 300 mass shootings so far this year.
bipartisan